Now, good morning, children. Now, let us see exercise 9.1, third question. A contractor plans to install two slides for the children to play in a park. For the children below the age of 5 years, she prefers to have the slide whose top is at a height of 1.5 meters and is inclined at an angle of 30 degree to the ground. Whereas for elder children, she wants to have a steep height at a slide at a height of 3 meter and inclined at an angle of 60 degree to the ground. What should be the length of the slide in each case? That means two different slides are being made by the contractor. One is for the small children below 5 years of age. So for that, the height of that plane was given as like this. The slide was made like this. This is the slide, okay, whose height, this height is given as 1.5 meter, okay. And this base, this angle is made by the slide to the ground is 30 degree given. You have to find what? The height of the slide for the first case, that is for small children. You can write here for children below 5 years or less than 5 years. This is the slide where and slide makes an angle 30 degree. And the height of this particular, this one is given as 1.5, okay. The height of the top is given as 1.5. You have to find the height of the slide, okay. So for this, you know that angle is given and P is given, because angle's opposite side is what? Perpendicular P, and this is B, this is H. Means hypotenuse, you have to find hypotenuse. So we know that this is, suppose we have given as name A, B and C. So what it will be? BC upon AC equals to sine 30 degree. We know this means sine theta. We have know the particular exercise 8.1. We have seen the formula, trigonometric ratios 1. Sine theta equals to P upon H. So here BC is what? Perpendicular P, and AC is the hypotenuse. Okay, that is equals to sine 30 degree. Implies, now what is BC? BC is given as 1.5 meter. Upon AC equals to sine 30 value is what? 1 upon 2. So now cross multiply. So AC will be equals to 1.5 meter into 2, which is equals to how much? 3 meter. That means the height of the slide for children below 5 years equals to how much? 3 meter. Okay, height of the slide we got, that is 3 meter for small children. Same way for elder one. For elder one again, the figure will be like this, and this is 60 degree, and this height is given as what? 3 meter. The height of this one is given as what? 3 meter. Okay, this one is 3 meter, this is 60, and this slide height you have to find, that is H you have to find. This is B and this is P. Again, P upon H sine 60 will find term. So for, you can write for children above 5 years, 5 years, height, that is the angle of elevation is given as what? Angle of elevation equals to 60 degree, okay, and height is given as, height equals to how much? 3 meter, okay. Then we have to find what? The slide, height of the slider, okay, height of the slide, that is hypotenuse we have to find, okay. So you can write here, according to trigonometric ratios, what is given? Angle is given, P is given. You have to find H, means P upon H equals to sine 30, okay. That particular ratio we will use, so that is implies, so you can again give as the name A, B and C. So you can write BC upon AC equals to sine 60, okay. So here BC is given as 3 meter upon AC equals to sine 60 is how much? Root 3 upon 2. Now cross multiply, so what we get? That is AC equals to 3 meter into 2 upon root 3, which is equals to how much? 6 upon root 3 meter. Again, you know that in denominator what you got? Root 3, means again you have to go for what? Rationalization, that is equals to 6 into root 3 upon root 3 into root 3, numerator and denominator. So what you get? 6 root 3 upon 3 equals to 2 root 3, okay. So therefore you can write, thus the height of the slide equals to how much? 2 root 3 meter. Here also meter and here meter. Answer. Now see children, question number 4. The angle of elevation of a top of a tower from a point on the ground which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower. Suppose this is the tower, okay. From the foot of the tower, the person is standing here and seeing the height top of the tower, okay. This is the tower, okay. So the person, whoever is standing here and seeing the tower, the elevation of this particular tower, seeing the tower one, that is how much? 30 degree, okay, clear. And from the foot of the ground to the tower, foot of the tower to the particular person, whoever is standing and seeing the tower, this distance is how much? 30 meter. That means what? Base is given, you have to find the height of the tower, means P you have to find, because this is the angle, means the angle's opposite side is what? Perpendicular. So this is perpendicular, this is base. And suppose this is A, B and C, then this is height, and that is hypotenuse, okay. So now we have to find the height of the tower, that is P, okay. So you can write here, now BC is the tower, height of the tower which we have to find, okay. Then AB is the base which is equals to 30 meter, okay. And angle of elevation is how much? Angle of elevation equals to how much? 30 degree. So we have to find the height of the tower, that means P. So B is given and P we have to find. So which trigonometric ratios we will take? That is P by H. P by H is which formula? Which trigonometric ratios formula? That is tan theta. Is it not? So here tan theta means how many degrees? 30 degree. So tan 30 formula we will take. That is equals to, we can write here, that is BC upon AB, which is equals to P upon B, equals to how much? Tan 30 degree. So here tan sin changes when your, which particular part we have to find. Seeing the question only, this tan or sin or cos, it changes. Okay, clear? So now P by B ratio, in which particular trigonometric ratios we use? Because B is given, we have to find P. Okay, so B with P means what? Tan, in tan we used to get, right? And again, suppose P with H means what? B with H means cos, and H with P means sine. So seeing the question only, your this trigonometric ratios changes. Trigonometric functions changes. It may be sine, it may be cos, it may be tan, anything. Okay, so now put the values of each. Now B value is given, that is 30. So that is, you can write BC upon 30 meter equals to tan 30 is how much? 1 upon root 3. Okay, so implies what? BC will be equals to 30 meter upon root 3. So which will be equals to what? 30 root 3 upon 3. Because same rationalization one, root 3 numerator, denominator, you will multiply and you will get like this. Now 3 ones are 3, tens are, this much meter equals to 10 root 3 meter. Okay, so height of the tower will be how much? Thus, you can write thus, the height of the tower equals to 10 root 3 meter. Answer. Okay? Children, fifth question is your homework. Fifth question is, a kite is flying at a height of 60 meter above the ground. The string attached to the kite is temporarily tied to a point on the ground. The inclination of the string with the ground is 60 degree. Find the length of the string, assuming that there is no slack in the string. Now, only the figure I am showing you, and you solve this question as homework. Now, see, the kite is flying, suppose here. Okay, the height of the kite is given. Okay, the height of the kite is 60 meter above. Okay, it is given. And from the ground, the thread of that string of that kite is tied like this. There is no slack means what? The string is held very tightly. Okay? Held very tightly means it is making a straight line, complete straight line. Okay? With an inclined angle is 60 degree. Okay? Likewise. Now this is given 60 degrees, opposite side is perpendicular. Perpendicular is given as 50 meter. You have to find the height of the string. That means hypotenuse you have to find. Hypotenuse you have to find. Okay. So to find this, you know P is given. And P with H means which particular trigonometric ratios you will go for? Sine. Sine 60. Sine 60 equals to P upon H. So P is given. Sine 60 value you know. Then you can find easily the hypotenuse. Okay. So solve this question as homework. Now let us move to the next question, that is sixth question. Okay, now sixth question is what? Sixth question is your homework. Okay, homework is the sixth question. Okay, sorry, fifth one. Fifth question is your homework. Okay, fifth one is your homework. Now sixth question, see, 1.5 meter tall boy is standing at some distance from a 30 meter tall building. Means suppose here a boy is standing, okay, of 1.5 meter height, okay, and in front of him there is a big building of 30 meter height. Okay, now after that what is given? The angle of elevation from his eyes to the top of the building is from 30 degree and to 60 degree as he walks towards the building. Find the distance walked by him. So now see, the boy is of 1.5 meter, okay, and a building height is 30 meter. So the height means parallel line, line of sight will be like this, okay, and this is the ground level, okay, and from here the person is, that particular boy is seeing the top of the building like this, making an angle of 30 degree. And this boy, when he walked here, up to here he walked, okay, he walked like this and reached here. So when he reached here, from here when he sees the top of the building, then he makes what? 60 degree. Okay, so you have to find how much distance he walked. This distance you have to find. Okay, distance you have to find how much he walked. So for that, first we will see what? Suppose this is A, B, C, and this point is D, suppose. Okay, so now in first figure, that is in A, B, C. In A, B, C, the height of that particular building. Height of the building is how much? Height of the building. Building equals to 30 meter. Okay? And height of the boy is how much? Height of the boy equals to how much? 1.5 meter. So from here, B to C is what is the height? Now then, BC equals to what? The height of the building. Building. Height of the building minus height of the boy. Height of the boy. Clear? Because this height I have to subtract from this building. Because this must height is the height of the boy. So that's why BC will be how much? BC from here to here. What is BC? Total height of the building minus the boy, height of the boy. So that is equals to what? 30 meter minus 1.5 meter. So which will be equals to 28.5 meter. So this is what? This particular BC is how much? 28.5 meter. Now this is known to us. This angle is known to us. So can we find this base? B, this is P. For this angle, this BC is P. P is given. And B can we find with which trigonometric ratios? That is tan 30. Tan means P upon B. Right? So what will you do? So you can write AB upon BC. First P upon B. Na? So BC upon AB equals to tan 30 degree. Okay. Which implies what? BC is given as how much? Just now we have taken out, that is 85.5 meter, 28.5 meter upon AB equals to what? Tan 30 is 1 upon root 3, which is equals to how much? AB equals to 28.5 into root 3. Okay. And meter. Okay, this is the height of this. This is the base of this particular ground. Okay. So AB equals to how much? 28.5 into root 3 meter. So this is the length of AB. AB length means this whole distance. Okay. Now we will take the triangle as, now here we can take in triangle BDC. Okay, now what? This particular, this one, that is BC upon, here you can write angle of elevation in triangle. This angle of elevation is how much? Angle of elevation equals to 60 degree. You can see here, angle of elevation is 60 degree. And P is how much? That is BC equals to how much? 28.5 meter. Okay, so therefore what? Again, B we have to find, P is given, angle is given. So what you will do? That is BC, that is P upon B, that is BD equals to how much? Tan 60. Okay, now implies this will be what? BC is how much? 28.5 upon BD equals to tan 60 is how much? Root 3, which implies what? BD equals to cross multiply, that is 28.5 upon root 3. Okay, so which is again, rationalize it. So what, by rationalizing what you will get? 28.5 into root 3 upon root 3 into root 3, which is equals to 28.5 root 3 upon 3. So 3 ones are 3, 9s are 3, 5s are, so equals to 9.5 root 3 meter. Okay, so now BD is known to us. This is how much? 9.5 root 3, and this whole distance is how much? We got 28.5 root 3, this whole distance. So now, this distance how will you get? That is the distance, the distance covered by the boy equals to total distance, that is AB, minus the distance of BD, which is equals to how much? AB is how much? We got just now here. AB is 28.5 root 3 minus BD is how much we got? 9.5 root 3 meter. This is also meter. So which is equals to how much? On subtracting, that is 0.19 root 3 meter, or you can write 19 root 3 meter. Okay, thus you can write, thus the boy traveled how much? 19 root 3 meter. Answer. This is the answer.